Right, howdy, howdy. I've been asked by some of my friends if I could do a longer Let's Play video of Resident Evil 7, specifically Madhouse mode, because people want to see me suffer. So that's what I'm going to do here. Post them on YouTube and then link them across to Facebook if anyone wants to watch them. If you don't, fair enough. I'm not doing full YouTube audio commentary because, yeah, fuck that, that's why. So yeah, if you want to see me suffer, watch these and enjoy. Have fun.
Just wanted to send a quick hello, and I love you. Oh, good news. I'm gonna be coming home soon. Yay! Oh, I cannot wait to be done with this babysitting job and come home to my loving husband. I miss you. Oh, I gotta get back to work. I love you, Ethan. I miss you so much. I'm sending tons of kisses.
Bye, baby. Ethan. You were right. I did lie to you. I shouldn't have. All I can say is that if you get this, stay away.
Hello?
Hey, it's Ethan.
Oh, hey. You all right? You just disappeared the other night.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I'm good. I'm good. It's Mia. She's not dead. She's alive. She's back.
They found her? How? What happened?
I don't know. Look, I don't know how, but she's back. She's back somehow. Maybe it's a prank, but she wants me to come and get her.
Where is she?
Dolby, Louisiana.
Dude, it's been 3 years.
I know, but what if it is her? I have to find out what happened. This is the place.
While we're just loading up here and starting as well, just to add a small disclaimer, the first hour of this is, for anyone else that's watched me do the gameplay videos of this on Facebook already, is going to be familiar and boring as fuck. The only difference is the Mia fights will be a shit ton harder, including requiring to give her 21 headshots before you take her down. If you still want to watch, go ahead. If not, it's cool as well. Again, for my suffering, watch and have fun in a bit.
Thank you.
One of the biggest noticeable differences in this playthrough is that you now have the limited saves in Madhouse, so you have to pick up the cassettes. Like so, once you use one, it disappears. So you only have a limited amount of saves. And that comes into play in a big way later. As you can see so far, there is very little difference until you start fighting stuff, so this beginning bit will mostly be the same. Quick secret reveal if anyone's looking for it. As this loads, you're playing as a cameraman, Clancy Jovis. In this bit, you may remember from the demo, where these two assholes are talking. If you take two steps back, lockpick. When we get into the house, you use that in one of the drawers. You'll be able to unlock a drawer from your main character in the future. You can go back in there and get your first antique coin. You need them for extra weapons.
Don't be surprised if we have to make a change. New plan. We do a walkthrough of the inside first, then we shoot the intro.
Just like we always do.
Just try to say the show's name this time, okay?
No problem. Tonight on Sewer Gators, another worthless fucking shithole. Happy?
Ecstatic. Are we rolling? All right, let's go.
Get out of the way.
It's locked.
After you.
So, why are we in hell this time?
Do you ever prep?
What's the prep? Shitty house, spooky sounds? Ooh, is it haunted? I was an anchor, you know?
Weekend sub, Pete. Not anchor.
What's that?
Nothing.
What's the story, Andre?
Abandoned farmhouse, missing family, foul play suspected. The usual.
How long did you say this place has been abandoned?
3 years.
Clancy, get a shot of this. Let's make a great cutaway. So, Hillbilly Joe and his family go missing.
Not hillbillies, the Bakers. Jack and Marguerite Baker. And they were quiet, not backward. A lot of bad rumors about their son, Lucas. Bad seed, apparently.
Ah, shit! I know I should have worn my good shoes. Oh, shit. Glad I had my shots. Although, this will make a great backdrop. Andre, what do you think? Andre? Andre!
This is the drawer you use the lockpick on. Go back once you get back to your normal time.
Where is he? Unfucking believable! unbelievable. This is the last time I work with that guy. I mean, producers, they come and go, but a good cameraman like you, Clancy, you stick with me. What the fuck was that? Did you hear that? Andre? Where the fuck is he? Andre, where are you, man? You gotta be fucking kidding me. All right, new deal. We find Andre and we go. I mean, fuck this show. You first. Need a nice hero shot of me coming down the ladder. So, you first.
Just had to comment on this. What a whiny little bitch. And yes, I will be dropping in and out of commentary for the whole video.
Jesus.
So as video game logic would have us dictate, we go down into the rape dungeon that Andre just died in. Which, you know, makes absolutely perfect sense.
Damn it. Thank God I found you. It's me. It's Ethan.
Ethan? Ethan?
Are you all right?
You shouldn't be here.
What do you mean? You contacted me.
No, no, I wouldn't. Did I? Did anyone see you? Did he see you?
Who else is here? What the hell's going on?
Daddy's coming. We need to go.
Daddy?
We need to go now!
Where are you taking me?
Someplace safe.
Are you gonna tell me what's going on? Baby, you've been gone 3 years.
3 years? Has it really been 3 years?
What is this place? What'd they do to you?
Not now. We need to get out of here first. I think it's this way.
Mia, we have to talk. That message you sent me.
Not me. That wasn't me.
But you did.
I didn't.
Okay, fine. Just tell me what's going on.
I'm telling you everything that I know. We have to go this way.
Mia, are you sure you know where you're going?
Family used to bring me food through here. I remember. There. It's there. This is it. I remember this room. There's another door here. I'm sure of it. It's not here. It's gone. It's gone! Oh, we're gonna be a family now that you're here. There's another door here. I'm sure of it.
Mia.
We gotta get out of here.
Just stay here, all right? I'm gonna have a look around.
No, leave me alone!
Mia?
Right, since we all know what's coming, there's no point in not breaking the tension. Mia fights, first part of Mia fight's about to come up. You'll notice the differences in Madhouse. She nearly kills you, regardless of how much you manage to resist the knife attacks. Potentially, this is the first time we could get close to dying. I should be able to manage to survive it, to move on to the next part. And we know what comes next.
back inside of me. Get out! Leave me alone! I've been bad. I deserve this.
There we have it, death. It's a problem, she is literally that deadly now. Okay, let's see where it restarts us from. I think the autosave was just before we actually got to the Mia fight. If you don't block or slice at the right time, that's it, you're fucked. Yeah, so back getting the first aid medicine again. Getting the guest house map. The noises begin now. Alright, let's try again, see if I can actually kill her this time. Right, same again. See if I can heal up a bit. See if I can take her this time. And done. Yeah, it's still close to death, though. I've also never seen a guy murder his wife quite so calmly and not be that shocked afterwards. Just pointing out.
You really shouldn't have come here.
Who's this? And what the fuck is going on?
My name's Zoe. There should be a way out through the attic.
Attic?
Go there. Now.
Mia?
So Mia's gone. Left me the nice presence of an axe. Gonna do absolutely fuck all against her if we run out of ammunition in a little while. So have a little look around. Yeah, she blatantly crawled past here. Black, more black than red, this blood. That's a bit more normal. Although nothing about this is normal. Right, through here. Don't forget you unlocked that drawer earlier with the lockpick on the with the camera crew. The antique coin is here. Yes, we did just see Mia walk past there. So she is still alive.
It's okay, it's me. I know you didn't mean to hurt me.
You shouldn't have done that! It fucking hurts!
I always wondered why she seemed obsessed with cutting my hands up. I really don't know. Now we have just a stump. Perfectly normal, not bleeding out or anything, you know. I mean, all that blood is fucking mine. But I guess I better take my hand with me. Because reasons. And move on, since I'm not dying. Right, I'm going to make my one and only save in the guest house here before we fight Mia. As I said before, limited saves, you need cassettes. Because autosave saves only very rarely as well. Luckily it saves enough here in the guest house, but later on you're looking at hours between autosaves. You do not want to lose that data. Right, let's see if I can fight and beat me in one attempt. I very much doubt it.
Okay. Fine.
Fuck me. Well, we managed to defeat her first time, which is fucking rare. I'm fucked up though. Luckily I had the hatchet to just do one last shot. So that's Madhouse Mia beaten.
Welcome to the family, son.
Motherfucker. Ouch.
Don't you die on us now. You have work to do.
Stapling my arm back on. Pretty sure that's not how anatomy works, but hey. This is Resident Evil.
What the hell?
Rise and shine, sleepyhead. It's time for supper.
Who are all you people? Where's Mia?
Eat it. It's good.
Dumb some bitch wasn't no good if it hit him.
Yes.
No, man, not again.
Get out the way, Margaret. Hit-Boy's got to eat. He got to have his supper. Come here, boy. Just do this. Come on.
Shit, he's not eating it, Jack! He's not eating it!
Get the hell up, Marguerite!
I'll make that for him!
Get the hell out of here!
You're a son of a bitch! Oh, I can't believe it! He's a son of a bitch! He's not eating it! He's not eating it!
This was supposed to be a very special feast. Come on, boy.
God damn it! I'll bet it's that cop again!
Goddamn pigs! I'm coming back for you.
Oh, the autosave just kicked in, so we'll leave it there, and I'll pick up in the next hour of Resident Evil 7.